Hey, everybody. Thanks for joining us here for NCAA college football action on Sports Media Network. College football at its finest, PS3, EA Sports, NCAA 14, with the 2015 download roster. That's right, college football. Two great matchups to bring to you today. Two great updates. Michigan, South Carolina, triple overtime. Number two greatest game of all time. Eastern Michigan got blanked by Miami of Ohio, 0-14. The Bob and Dave split a win. Let's jump right into the highlights of this great ESPN Classic game. South Carroll. Looks like a broken pass play. He's going to run, but the last second, pulls up, bing, zips it in, finds his receiver, touchdown. Beautiful play. Now here's a Michigan touchdown. Start of the second quarter. Steps back to the 3-yard line, really burns it in here. Receiver kind of standing alone, defender's back turned toward him. A little too late to turn around and stop. You're going to love this. Here in the third quarter, South Carolina runs a QB keeper, breaking tackles, rumbling, bumbling, stumbling, 19 yards, touchdown! On this highlight, Michigan throws a 30-yard TD pass to close out the first half. Bang, touchdown. We're tied at 14 at half. Now, just a minute into this third quarter, Michigan throws a nice TD pass. Keep your eye on the upper left-hand corner. Oh, yeah, nice pass. Touchdown. Here's a South Carolina touchdown. They toss it out to the right. Pretty simple play. Got single coverage. Man backs up a bit, gives the receiver some room. A little weak contact. Number four trails in for a nice South Carolina touchdown. Now South Carolina is still down by 8. They need some help at this point. And with 3:31 left, they get it. Big pick. South Carolina gets it down to the 50-yard line. They need 8. Time ticking off on this game. Now this is the last play of the game. Down by 8. South Carolina takes the snap. Michigan in man coverage. Ties up all the receivers. They break. Receivers break over the middle. Receiver bats it up in the air. Catches it. 2-point conversion. College football overtime. Here's your rules. Michigan gets the ball to start the overtime. They throw a nice little pass over the middle to number 85, his second touchdown on the day. Nice crossing route. See this real quick in slow-mo. Nice drop back by the quarterback. Burns it over the middle. No real coverage in the middle. Initiates a little contact. Almost a strip. Touchdown. Now, sure enough, South Carolina answers. They have a one-play toss out to a single-covered wide receiver, 4. He brushes off the defender. It's a touchdown. Ties it up. Now, in the second overtime, I don't have any replays. Michigan does throw an interception, so all South Carolina had to do was kick the field goal, but they kicked a 38-yarder after a sack, missed it, and we go into overtime 3. In third overtime, Michigan gets the ball. They spot their man over the middle on a crossing play. Wide open. Touchdown. Now, in college football, you have to go for 2 in the third overtime. And here's Michigan's attempt. Now there's coverage over the middle. Nobody open now. They try that crossing route once again, but sure enough, man in the middle. Bats it down. Incomplete. So now it's a 6-point difference. And so South Carolina needs a touchdown to tie. 2-point conversion to win. They got their man open for their touchdown. They throw it over, but some kind of superhuman dive by a Michigan defender gets a touchdown to win the game. Triple overtime. Unbelievable. You see the receiver break here. He looks wide open. Wide open. And then zing, superhuman dive by Michigan. Unbelievable interception. Fantastic game, folks. You don't believe that. Look at that grab. Superhuman grab. Unbelievable. I'm just glad I got a chance to bring some of these to you. These plays, unbelievable. Here's your stats. I got to show you these first half stats. Look at this passing. 10 for 10 for South Carolina. 9 for 9 for Michigan. No incompletes. Unbelievable. What a first half. Clock virtually the same. 6 minutes each. Had to show you that. Now your game stats here. Rush is pretty minimal. They had to go to the air to get anything going, and a lot of air they got. Third downs, stingy. Fourth downs, 100% for each of them. Just amazing. 2-point conversion to seal the game. That was your big difference. Red zone, both of them putting it in when they get close.
450, 480 yards, respectively. Look at these six touchdowns by the Michigan quarterback, generally. South Carolina quarterback, five touchdowns. Pretty minimal rushing on Michigan's part. South Carolina did get some yardage on the ground here with Wilds. Tight end caught the ball for South Carolina. Lots of big catches. They spread the ball around nicely. Very few drops. For Michigan, their receiving corps, all tight end. T. Kimmel, 8 for 102. Kept it nice and tight. Post-game stats summary shows South Carolina needing that 11 points in the fourth quarter to go to overtime. They ran the ball. But those six touchdowns by Zach Gentry, 22 for 29, 367 yards. Bryson Williams tried to run the ball, five carries, 40 yards, and then he threw for five touchdowns. But really, man, what a game. Michigan pulls it out. Woo! Oh, hey, I wanted to give one quick look. I know I promised you this. Another look at that touchdown for South Carolina that sent him into overtime. And that was the case where the receiver knocks it up in the air and catches it with no time on the clock. Talk about, you know, having your panties in a little bunch there, because you got to make this catch. Quarterback drops back way too far, but as we remember, that man defense has got him tied up. You can see the two safeties standing in the middle in a two-man zone, but you know what? Receivers break here to the left, and I just really wanted to see this bobble once more. I didn't have it in the regular series, so I had to plug it in the end here. Thanks for sticking around for this. You see this receiver break. Had to see this bobble. You really can't see it in full motion, in full full motion view, so I had to do a slow-mo. Boom! And knocks it up in the air here, and there's a crowd. Who even knocks it up in the air? It looks like the receiver. It's floating around. I'm thinking the other guy's going to catch it, or it's certainly going to hit the ground. I'm thinking that the game's over. Because the ball's floating around, and then all of a sudden, right in the middle of the L in Carolina, he's singing the blues. No siree. He's singing the woohoo, because that's the catch that puts him into overtime, ladies and gentlemen. Anyway, I had to show you. Well, hey, everybody. Thanks for sticking around. Here's that undercard matchup, Miami-Ohio Redhawks against Eastern Michigan. You're going to see him come out here in a hurry-up sequence. We haven't really showed anything like this before. Clock shows 4:20 in the first quarter. Sorry about that plant. There's a quick screen by Miami. That's incomplete, but they do a hurry up here. Now they audible to a back out of the flat play. Here's your audible. Out of that two tight end set. Shifts everybody to the left. Now watch your halfback here. He's going to come over the middle. And check out this in-game hurry up sequence recording. There's a fake. There goes your R1. Halfback, boom, over the middle, 11 yards, first down. Now this is play three of this hurry-up sequence. Eastern Michigan sticking with a hurry-up. Sorry about that plant. Now they're two running backs set. Remember, those two tighter ends are in, and they're still in. Now they audible to a toss left. Miami doing shifting on defense, but it looks like most of their guys are to the right, so this should be a good... Oh, nope, toss right, my bad. And they weave through some good blocking for 6 yards. Eastern Michigan decides to huddle up. Now, a quick editor's note here. I did substitute my halfback two in for my tight end number two. So if I come out in a two tight end set like I am here in the ace big, the left tight end will always be the second string halfback. So speed is always in play, even with a two halfbacks, two tight end set. And you see me in the two tight end set, that is a for sure. Sorry about the plant. A little runoff right guard yields three. I kind of ran into the tackler. Okay, we're second and seven. Eastern Michigan coming out in the ace jumbo. They're going to run a power option right. On the short side. Or just a handoff right. Not much gain there, leaving third and five. Now a big third down here. They're in the hurry up. Going back into that ace jumbo. They do call a halfback dive right. They pull into the sequence. Now you can see the defense in kind of a quarter. So the run may work here. There's an audible to a pistol Y dive right. Defense is making adjustments here. I audible to a run to the left then. Seeing it, he's emptying the left side, so I figured I made a good play here. Good call. I switch it to the left here. And boom, pick up a little block and just to the yellow line. That's a first down, baby. So that's a nice first down, midfield. I'm getting out of that two tight end set here. I'm going to the shotgun split offset. You'll see me sub in the halfback, the star halfback number 30 over on the right side. Split receiver. It's going to put my speedy back, my best star guy, out in play. I'm going to run that Y cross, so that halfback will run across the field, opening him up. The play on the left there, that Y cross, is coming back up here. There he is, Y cross. That's going to get that X receiver, that halfback, that star guy. He's going to be speeding out there. I want this first down. I'm smelling field goal range. And there goes that halfback. Nobody out in the middle. He burns that baby in. Ooh, all the way down to the 10-yard line. Now, this play's a real doozy. Now, you see my halfback, number 30, star guy. He's all yellow or orange, so he's pretty burnt. And I sub him out of here. And what I'm thinking is I'll just sub in any old back, you know, my sub halfback to give this guy a rest. And I'll call a QB keeper. A QB's got a little speed to him. And there I go, shifting out the back. You see him disappear, and that'll put in the choosing the spell halfback. So this is a guaranteed run all the way. I call the four vertical. Send all the receivers downfield, knowing full well I'm just going to split this quarterback out. Sorry about the plan. But this works beautifully. All except the very end. Look at how wide open this is. I give a little extra effort. Boom, fumble. What? Turnover? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? And that's just an example of how this game went. Here's a slow-mo replay. I think if we'd have had the ability to challenge, I'd have got this. Because that ball comes out and it touches the sideline right there. Clearly out of bounds. But the fumble sign comes up. And we're playing online here, and there are no replays online, so I didn't even think about it because we play online a lot. Oh, man, look at that baby. Is she out, ladies and gentlemen? Can I get some love? That's not a fumble. That's out of bounds. That's ball out of bounds. Eastern Michigan doesn't get the nod, so it's Miami's ball on the 5-yard line. Unbelievable, sports fans. Now this next play is going to blow you away. A double fumble. Miami up the gut. Fumble. Okay, so I'm thinking I got it. And then no, a fumble back. A double fumble. Never before seen, folks. And here's a little slow-mo shot at it. Big time contact. Ball on the ground. It's all green. Green on top of the ball. He should have just stayed down. He might have been down. Another replay case where I might have been able to get some love. The camera switches. I got the ball. I'm thinking, oh, I righted the wrongs of the world. Boom, what? Another fumble? Yeah, camera does their swing. That's another fumble. A double fumble. Unbelievable, sports fans. Now, Miami does have to punt the ball, and Eastern Michigan drives all the way down into scoring range, and lo and behold, bang, they throw another pick. Oh, sports fans, that's twice on the 1-yard line. Denied, big pick. Two turnovers each at this point. Now, Miami runs the ball to open the second half. Three wide receivers left, and you can see there's plenty of blocking as the receivers took away the defenders. Now, on first down, Miami sticks with the run. Spencer McGinnis, second six, up the gut. Now, Miami's going to pass on this second and six. In a bunch. There's pressure. Boom! Fumble! Thought I was going to get the ball, but they jump on it. Miami recovers. Third and 17. They come out in a four-wide set. Looks like tight defense. They go over the middle. Incomplete. Now, Miami punts away, and you can see this defensive struggle they're under. The defense is very, very good. Offense is pretty mediocre. So they're having to be a bit creative here. Trying to do what get yards. Nice punt here. No gain. EMU comes in out of the I formation with the ball. They're going to keep it stingy. They're going to run the ball. There's 4 minutes left. This second and seven play is again going to show you how tight and stingy these defenses are. EMU comes out of a pistol slot. They're going to run a cross pass over the middle. Defense taking a minute to get their play in. 4:06 left in the second. No score. Here comes your cross pass. Well, they got a man. They get the ball. Stingy D, couple yards. 3rd and 3 in the pistol, 2 tight end. But remember, I have that halfback 2 subbed in at the tight end slot. I do throw to the tight end here, but darn, blanket coverage. Pretty good coverage. I just put it to myself out of bounds. Led myself out of bounds. Well, I got a punt. On 2nd and 8 here, Miami runs it up the gut. I'm in a nickel cover 2 disguise, so they break this first tackle. Boom, there's a little bit of opening. They grab it. Big 11-yard gain. Nice run. Aggies Huskers. Now, this is a nice first down run. I'm in a 5-2 pinch defense, and I audible to a run primary. So I should have been able to smash this run, but McGinnis, well, man, breaking tackles, 1, 2, 3, 4. Is anybody going to bring him down? Oh, beautiful run. Let's go ahead and see that run one more time for the slow-mo action. Coming up, how many tackles does he break? Let's see, right in him, 1, 2. There's a 2-man gang tackle, 3. They're stripping that ball, 4. The star guy can't break, 5. Let's see, there's a guy dragging on him, 6. Star guy's back, 7. His own guys can't bring him down, 8, 9. His own guys hold him up, or I probably never would have got the guy. Damn, what a run. Woo! Dun, 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 dun. All right. Now, Miami here looks heavy. 2 tight ends, 2 backs. You think they're going to run, but no. They throw it over the middle. He got more yards, but he had to run backwards a little. Clock is ticking with 1:06 left in the second half. They've got 2 wide receivers right. They switch. Audible, 2 wide receivers left. Defense sticks with them. They're in the nickel. Man, beautiful blocking. Wall of blockers. Big first down. Tick, 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 tick. Now, Miami in the big, heavy 3 tight end set here. Clock still ticking. 35, tick. They audible a little run up the gut. They bring the tight end for blocking. He gets good yards. 1st and 10, midfield. Miami, 4 tight ends, star receiver left. They throw a little screen, but he just gets a couple yards. Tick, 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 tick. 20 seconds, 3rd and 2. They're in the hurry up. Miami doesn't like to run the hurry up, but they do. 16, 15, clock ticking. Hurry up, offense. Defense has been sticking to them like glue. 3rd and 2. They go over the middle. The defense makes him squirt out the last second. Big D, and that's just an example of how this game is going, man. Tough. Now, 4th and 2, you might be thinking they just punted away, but no, they go for it here. They get a nice wide receiver off to the right. 1st down, 30-yard line. They're sniffing field goal range. And they bring out the field goal unit. This could be a biggie. 47-yarder. Or a 51-yarder. Unbelievable, sports fans. Defense wasn't the Velcro 9. It was wide left. Didn't have enough juice either. Wide left! Danger, danger. Quick review of the first half stats. Eastern Michigan 5 for 7. Miami of Ohio 5 for 8 passing. Judicious, but not a lot of yards. Rushing for Miami of Ohio, 72 yards. That's the best stat of the day. While Eastern Michigan only 5 for 19. So Miami, and the receiving stats, pretty anorexic. 5 catches in the first half there, and 5 catches for Miami of Ohio. Dishing it out. Miami of Ohio starts the second half by getting a pick 6 right here. Boom. Picks it off. What a play. After all that defense, a pick 6 to start the second half. And Miami gets the ball back and has this nice rushing TD out of the bunch formation. Get one little tackle here. Boom. Breaks it. Boom. Wide open. Lots of blocking. Beautiful play. Wasn't expecting the run. And why not review that one more time in slow motion ad nauseum as it breaks right and breaks a tackle. Almost too easy out of a defensive struggle so far. And why not a ground view shot of that game-winning touchdown, 14-0. This was the icing on the cake. Touchdown. Eastern Michigan gets the ball back and drives down for almost a touchdown again, but intercepted on the goal line. With 5 minutes, 48 seconds left in the game, they're going downfield. Here's a replay again, that big pick with 5:48 left. the third interception on the day. Now Miami of Ohio gets another interception as Eastern Michigan's going deep. Got single coverage, but can't come up with it. Nice big pick, turn around, runs it back to the 50, but again, Eastern Michigan's going to hold him here defensively and get the ball back. One more quick look at that pick. This little ISO slow-mo. Bing. That is a big pick. Did he step out of bounds? 10-yard run back. And with a minute 38 left, Miami of Ohio, or Eastern Michigan, trying to shot downfield again to come back, at least get a score and an onside kick, but no. But no, Miami of Ohio now, this slow tight end, getting jumped by the speedy linebacker here, steps in front, number 27, big pick, sealing the game. Unbelievable game, defensive struggle. The Miami of Ohio defense, unbelievable. Going to jump into this stat review real quick. Miami of Ohio, 25 rushes, 145 yards. Bang. That and the defense is going to bring you home a winner, baby doll. Six interceptions Eastern Michigan threw, seven total turnovers, clock, possession. There's your QB rating of 40.3, 10 attempts, 10 catches on 25. You got six interceptions. You had four drops. Yeah, Miami of Ohio, not any better. 70.1% rating on 7 for 13 and a pick. You got to see these rushing stats, though. 18 rushes, 140 yards, 54 yak yards. This is some beautiful work by Spencer McGinnis. Eastern Michigan probably should have stayed with the run a little bit more, but they had to sell out being behind and go for that passing. And passing pretty anemic here with only three catches by the tight end. Should have been more production in that arena. Should have been more production in the halfback arena, too. But, man, talk about blanket defense by Miami of Ohio. Crediting Eastern Michigan for their defense as well. That dang petter-ass penalty couldn't even catch a ball there. One drop, for Christ's sake. All right, Miami of Ohio, you bet. They just spread it around a little bit. Seven catches, didn't even need it. Pick six was all they needed. Good times, brah. Whoa, 11 pancake blocks by the freshman out of Melrose Park, Illinois. Heidelman. Thanks for joining us, you guys, on this fateful trip. Oh, look at these defensive stats by Miami. Bang, solo tackles. Bang, interceptions. Oh, boy, you just can't. You can't even fit them on the board. We're going to have to scroll down here. Taylor, Payson, Montgomery. Never seen so many defensive stats in my life. Wow. Hey, thanks, Josh Sheedy, for the roster again. Thanks for joining us, everyone here at Sports Media Network. Love bringing these PS3 games of EA Sports NCAA Football 14 with a 15 platform. Yoop! See ya!